Mr. Chairman, the whole point of this program would be that we would take that out of the private sending it in, and these would be available in the canteen. And the canteen would have all of the goods untainted, not knowing who would buy the goods, and that the funds that they would use to send these items in a private package would actually be available in the canteen instead.
Are they going to search all of the stuff every day that goes into the canteen?
No, because the canteen right now, we've not had canteen problems, because the canteen items that go in...
Assuming, which I don't necessarily accept, that all of this stuff is clearly going on, then my next move would be to get a hold of a guy that works for the canteen delivery service and see what he could do with the Snickers bar, and you'd have to check everything before it goes into the canteen.
Well, at this point, we've not had problems with the canteen, Senator.
I understand that.
And obviously, that would be an easier place to trace back to than a return address on a package.
I thought you tried to stop the stuff coming in. I imagine it's easy to trace back to if you find out the drug came from me to you, or you to me, then your name would be on the package, and I have the drug to trace it back to you, so I mean...
But to prove that you actually packaged that package versus just use the return address is almost impossible.
Well, I would imagine if I was the boyfriend, you were the girlfriend, I was the husband, you were the wife, somebody was a nephew. I mean, I imagine, you know, people aren't getting packages from John or Jane Doe.
Yeah, except, Senator, the point of the program is to try, as you've said, to try to get as many of the drugs as possible out of the institution. This is one of the major ways it comes in. There are four other avenues that need to be addressed, but this bill just does one.
What are the other ones?
The five other ways?
Yeah.
Well, sir...
Employees, anyway?
Sir... Are
employees smuggling drugs?
I've been in Pelican Bay since July of 90. I have never heard of an instance where a correctional staff member at Pelican Bay...
No, I mean employee, not just...
Or any staff member, sir.
No.
Any kind of correctional staff member. I'm not aware of any correctional staff member at Pelican Bay that has been found guilty of bringing in drugs.
I'll call you back.
Senator Romero?
Yeah. Let me ask, I mean, overall, the CDC at a recent hearing testified that the problem of finding drugs or contraband in the packages sent by family members to inmates accounts for only 3% of the drugs that are found, you know, in the prisons. So
they only found 3%, Senator, because we don't have the sophistication. And I read that too, and it was a bit confusing. They found 3% of the drugs coming in. That just simply means that we don't have all the detection services that we need to have. I mean, their drugs are rampant in the facility. If there's five areas, and this is one of the key areas,
that may be the case. But again, I'm still looking at it over. I'm thinking 3% is a very small percentage. I'm trying to figure out what is the benefit of having such a program where you deny anything coming in, when CDC itself, and I'm confident in the resources of CDC at its point and in the future, in terms of determining and finding additional contraband.
Well, Senator, it's not denying anything coming in. It's changing the source of how it gets there. So it's an untainted product. They can still get tricks. They can still get Nike tennis shoes. They just have to go through a private vendor source coming in.
Tricks?
Yeah, cereal.
Cereal.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, you know... And it works out to be a better bang for the buck. I mean, obviously, if it's a private vendor going into the canteen or a private vendor in general, the tricks box doesn't have to be opened and make sure that every single one of the tricks doesn't have some kind of drug in it. I mean, it's almost impossible in the food areas to get the food there and have it still look like food.
What's the difference in price in a canteen and then food for less?
Well, I don't know if that's not apples and oranges, because...
Well, no, it is.
Well, I understand. Senator, just a second.
No, if I could, Paul. Mm-hmm. It is apples and apples, because if it's a dollar and a half for a Snickers at the canteen, and I can get them at food for less for 75 cents...
Okay, and the time and effort that it takes correctional officers to sit and look through every single package that comes in versus concentrating on another avenue...
I'm talking about the cost, you know, to the families of the...
The canteen, as written into regulation, is supposed to provide products at a reasonable price.
What does it cost? Does anybody know? Guards would probably know, huh?
No.
Double.
Was that a guard?
Somebody just said double. Okay, no, that's all right.
I understand. I mean, I think that there's a lot that goes into the products getting there. If it's just, would it be, if every package we could be assured of was a safe package that didn't have narcotics in it of any kind or any other contraband that's not acceptable, could be assured of going into the prison, then yeah, it's probably cheaper. But for the time and effort it goes into searching every single package, because they're privately sent, creates a great deal of problems. The bill was not introduced to be a burden on the families. And I know one of the areas that was addressed was, if it goes through the canteen, then you're looking at restitution funds above and beyond what they're already paying, if they're paying any restitution funds. That is not something that we would hope, we would think would bog down the bill, because as far as I'm concerned...
No.
I'm saying that we would be willing to take an amendment so that that doesn't bog down the bill, Senator. So that if you went to an outside vendor, there wouldn't be that restitution fund, as much as the victims like the restitution funds paid in. And if you went through the canteen instead, I think that we would be willing to take an amendment that said that the funds above and beyond going through this program did not take more money away for the restitution fund to go through the canteen. I mean, there are advantages to going to an outside vendor. The program wasn't meant to hurt families of inmates. It wasn't put in to stop vendor packages. It was put in to try and alleviate one of the major drug problems that we have.
You want to suggest that amendment, Senator, or does it make it? Sir, go ahead.
Sir, Rick Newton, Pelican Bay. I've got about 19 years in the department. I've seen a lot of violence over the years, okay? A lot of this violence includes drug wars, one side owing the other, okay? This is one way drugs are introduced to the institutions. We need to stop it, okay? To search a food item and to do it without destroying the item, you know, is essentially, to some degree, impossible. Okay. If we're going to take a zero tolerance position on drugs, okay, the canteen services has got many years of providing safe product to the inmate population. Okay. We haven't had that problem through the canteen services. They buy in bulk. When they buy coffee, they buy tons of coffee. Okay. It comes in bulk. Okay. There's no knowledge of who that coffee is going to. That specific can of coffee, okay? That's what needs to be done here. The drugs and violence go together, especially in the prison environment. Many of these inmates were of that drug culture that brought them to prison, and they continue that drug culture in prison. You know, this is one avenue to shut that down and stop it. Yes, there's other avenues, you know, and respectfully addressing what the Senator was speaking to, you know, I've got 19 years in, New Folsom, yes, there was an officer that was caught for bringing in drugs. It was officers that testified against him and put him in prison, you know. It's wrong. And if a fellow officer's doing that, he needs to go to prison. He needs to do time, because it's wrong, you know. Are there any questions?
That's one question.
Sure.
Mr. Chairman.
Senator Burton.
People in the shoe get these packages?
Yes,
they do.
Senator, everybody at Pelican Bay gets at least one package a year.
One a year?
1 to 4 a year. That's what the quarterly package.
Do you have to be have some kind of, I guess, good behavior, whatever?
Yeah, unless you've abused the package privilege, you can have 1 to 4.
How about if you've used other privileges in the prison? I have no idea what the answers are, so I'm just wondering. You have to, be on good behavior in the prison, too, or what?
Senator, we pass out packages just about every day in SHU, security housing.
Once a year. No, but I understand that. I just,